time to head to the guest room. And the lovely lady on the phone is a writer, director, and multimedia artist, Maya Wilkinson. Good morning.
Good morning.
How do you do?
I do well. How do you do?
I'm hungry, but let's not go there. Let's instead go with the hunger for information about your world and the way you manage it, Maya Wilkinson. So for those folks who are not in the circles of multimedia and theater, can you share with us some of the projects that you have worked on that folks would know about, probably went to see or have seen in execution?
Okay, so one of the productions I did most recently that had a good response was Heist.
Heist, H-E-I-S-T.
Yes, and so a lot of people came out to see it, and then I put the series on YouTube, and that has had a good response as well. In addition to that, I'm a member of Quilt, which is a local performing arts company.
Quilt, Q-U-I-L-T.
Yes.
Okay.
Some of the other work I do is with Michael Holgate from the Ashe Company and like university players at the University of the West Indies at the Philip Sherlock Center there. So, yeah.
Wow. Now, we want to know what the journey was that you took to get here, because I hear it involved the U.S., involved Guyana, and then Jamaica in those early years. Do you remember? Well, explain for the folks who don't know about that process.
Okay, well, my parents are Guyanese, but that's Guyana in South America, and it was actually an interesting reason that we came to Jamaica. So my mom had an accident. And the hospital situation in Guyana was far, I guess, below what was available here. So she came over to sort of recuperate and get some surgeries done. And then she ended up getting a job. She's a teacher, an English teacher, funnily enough. And she stayed. She fell in love with Jamaica and stayed. And I guess the rest is not history quite yet, but becoming history.
In the process of becoming history. So you came as a youngster with Guyanese parents in the Jamaican environment, and
yes.
how does that work? Is there a difference in culture when you're home versus when you step outside?
I think I merged in pretty easily because I was so much younger, but it is very different. I mean, everybody says it's English. We have Guyanese Creole versus Jamaican Creole, which is different, but again, the similarities of a Caribbean nation are there, so it was easy to fit in, I guess.
Mm-hmm. And the desire to be a part of the performing world and the artistic world, is that your own, or is that something you saw with your parents and home?
I think it was a little bit of both. My dad writes a bit of poetry, and my mother was into theater, but I think a lot of it comes from only child syndrome, because I was very imaginative, so I had to entertain myself growing up. And that came out in the form of whether art or me writing or talking to myself in the mirror.
And those are the things that you do now. You have art.
Actually.
You write. Do you still talk to yourself in the mirror?
Absolutely.
So she talks to herself on Twitter.
Yes.
With the most off-key sense of humor, which I absolutely love, one of your followers.
Thank you.
So let's talk about the writing somewhat. What has your writing matured into?
Well, no, it's strange. Before, I used to kind of just write for myself, as I said. And then, you know, during high school, I did JCDC, you know, so one and two things for festivals. But when I came to UE, Rayon McLean from Quilt read one of the pieces I wrote for his company, or not for his company, I had just written it as an exercise. And he thought it was, you know, worth putting on stage. So when he did that, it kind of changed my writing from just, you know, putting expression on pages to actually writing material that would be then transformed into other forms of entertainment for people to experience. And so I guess, yeah,
What is that difference? I mean, you're writing it, yes, but then what is the change that happens? Do you change the way the characters speak? Do you change the description? What changes? I think the story may be the same at heart, is it?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think the material itself that I write for to be experienced by an audience is very different. A lot of the more intimate work, or I would call it maybe the more research work, is what I do maybe as just poetry and journaling. And maybe some of that will become work that ends up on stage or on screen later. So I guess it's just more refined and more consideration for what an audience might enjoy and what might impact an audience in an important way.
And you interact with audiences in a different kind of way as a multimedia artist. That's a generic term, though. What does that mean? What do you do?
So I create digital art, and a lot of the times in my stage work and even in film work, I use projections, so multimedia projections or other forms of digital art to enhance the story or the telling of the story, or to bridge that gap between live art and the magic of the screen.
For some of us, we still don't know what you mean. Maya, what do I see? You create digital art. What does that mean?
So, for example, one of the productions I worked on with Michael Holgate was called Bone of Contention, and there was a cotton tree that was a main feature in the story. And so we had no physical cotton tree. We just created a digital tree with graphic design, and that was projected onto a backdrop. And then that gave us the freedom to sort of create special effects so the tree could move and change colors and transform and get bigger and smaller.
Wow.
And this was all done digitally.
Wow.
And then surrounding that was the live performance with the actors and the dancers. So I hope it's a bit clearer.
Absolutely. A huge difference from just a picture of a tree projected on a screen. Wow.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And where is the market for that outside of stage? How else does that multimedia artwork, how do we get to see it, or where else would we see that?
Well, it's interesting now that we've entered a phase where bridging this gap is almost unavoidable. You know, trying to still have theater enjoyed while they're not open. So I think having the multimedia is a way that we can sort of preserve the live elements. Quilt, we just worked on a project recently that was a play film, a plim, mm-hmm. our director calls it.
A plim.
So it is, we try to preserve live in the sense that we did things in one take. Mm-hmm. So all of the acting is live, even though it's recorded. And then within that, we did the same sort of thing where we created scenes from London using projections again. So we didn't build too much of a physical set. And this also reduces cost, because especially going into the future in a pandemic, you know, doing big budget films as small groups that was already tough.
Mm-hmm.
So this just, multimedia is a way to sort of innovate for the pocket and also the eye as well.
Okay. So you have fertilized, you've nurtured rather your creative streak all the way through. Let me see, folks. She was Berkeley High School, California with awards. She was at Carmack. Before that, what was the high school in Jamaica?
I went to Montego Bay High School for Girls in St. James.
And there was dance and drama there. When you came back, you were at the University of the West Indies, working and doing schoolwork, and you are now using that Bachelor of Arts you have in media and communications to create all sorts of things. How do people see you, follow you, hire you?
Okay, so on social media, I'm at Epic Myers, EPICMAYERS, and I have a YouTube channel that is just under my name, Maya Wilkinson. And what I do, which was also inspired by the whole lockdown and people not having access to theater, is I have put a lot of my work on the channel. So if you want to see clips of theater, they're there. And then the entire production, Heist, is also up on there, along with other work from Quilt. And then Quilt also has a YouTube channel where you can see specifically work from the company. And if you want to hire me, all of my contact info is on my social media pages.
And we just search Maya Wilkinson.
Yes.
And we got you. And we're happy we got you this morning. Thank you for sharing with us. All the best.
Thank you. You too.
Writer, director, multimedia artist, Maya Wilkinson, inside the guest room.